What's up everybody? It's Levi Ellis here. Thanks again for watching and welcome to a new episode of Crypto Edutainment 101. So these series are intended for people that are new to cryptocurrencies and want to know all the ins and outs. So today, I received something 2 weeks ago. What would it be? So let's open it. Ta-da! Trezor hardware wallet. Oh, in case you want to know what's in the package, some stickers, the Trezor itself. So this is how it looks like. It's pretty small as you can see. A USB cable. And two things to write out your recovery seeds. Don't ever lose this. If you recall, I've lost 3 bitcoins because I didn't save my private keys. Safety first. So today, I'm going to show you how to keep your bitcoin secure via a Trezor hardware wallet. But you can also do it via a paper wallet, and I've made some videos of that. If you missed it out, please see the link in the description. So let's go to the installation. So first of all, you need to have an interface to interact with your Trezor. For that, you need to go to wallet.trezor.io. I'm using Chrome, so I'm going to install a Chrome extension. If you want to use it in different browsers, you can also download the bridge. I'm running a Mac, so for me, I would choose the Mac OS X. So as soon as you have installed your Chrome extension, you can see right here that you need to connect your Trezor to continue. So let's do that. So as you can see, the first time that you plug in the Trezor, it is required to install some firmware first. So whenever it is confirmed, you will see this fingerprint and make sure that it is displayed the same on your device screen. I just double checked this on my Trezor and it is exactly the same code, so I click on continue on the Trezor. So now I'm going to unplug the device and reconnect it again. So you can give your device a label here. So whenever you fill out your PIN code, as you can see, you do not see the numbers on the screen on your computer. But actually, the numbers are randomly being displayed on your Trezor. So please ensure that you follow the numbers on your Trezor to generate your PIN code. Repeat it. So now you need to write out the combination of 24 words in the exact order without making any mistakes. Because if you lose this, you can never ever get back to your funds. Put down all the 24 words. It will ask you to double check it once more. And whenever you have done that, and you are 100% sure you have made no mistakes in the words and the orders, you can hit the finish button on the Trezor. It will ask you to enter your PIN code again. Be sure to follow the numbers on your Trezor. And your Trezor is ready to be used. So as you can see, this is the Bitcoin wallet. If you want to switch over to another coin, you simply click on it. And you can see you can switch over to a Dash wallet, a Zcash wallet, or an Ethereum wallet. Other than that, the other options like receiving payments and sending payments work as usual as on any other wallet. The only thing is that you need to sign it with your Trezor. So therefore, I'm not going to go in depth on those things.
because the purpose of this video was to show you how easy it is to install a Trezor.
So as you can see, it's pretty easy to install a Trezor. If you want to purchase a Trezor, please check the link below. I hope this video was helpful. Thanks again for watching. Peace out!